Hey guys, Dave Keller here with Market Misbehavior. I love to ask interviewees what their one chart would be. And that is, if you had one chart, just one chart, besides a regular chart of the S&P 500, as a way to understand the broad market environment, what would it be right now and why? So here is my one chart for today. Okay, so today's one chart is gold, $GOLD. It's in this is the continuous futures. Different ways to sort of look at gold. This is essentially the gold spot rate that we're paying attention to, not the GLD or one of the related ETFs. And you know, when I think about gold, I usually am asked very soon after about gold as a safe haven, right? If stocks are working, gold should not work because gold's a safe haven. Or if stocks are not working, gold should rally because gold's a safe haven. And I would say anytime you're thinking along those lines, you are definitely oversimplifying in terms of the relationship between stocks and gold. You know, a lot of people think that there's just sort of an inverse relationship, right? That when gold is going up, stocks are going down. When stocks are going up, gold is going down. And here's the thing, there are plenty of times when gold and stocks move inversely to one another and their correlation approaches negative one. But there are also plenty of times I could show you where gold and stocks rally together and where their correlation approaches more positive one. I think a perfect example of that is the middle of 2020. So if you look after the March market low, you had both gold and stocks rallying and overall the trend remained very strong. So the correlation was fairly strong. The correlation dissipated a bit because going into the September peak, you had gold actually peaking in August, coming off while stocks sort of accelerated into the September peak. So, you know, overall, and then the trend, you know, it was the equity markets accelerating into a new high in December while gold and other precious metals were sort of in a downtrend. So there are times when stocks and gold move together. There are times when they moved separately. So I would encourage you not to oversimplify. Having said that, there are plenty of times, you know, when stocks start to struggle and people are taking profits, they're getting out. The question always is, where do they park their assets? And that's this idea of the safe haven. And, you know, people have speculated, could gold be a safe haven? Absolutely. Could Bitcoin be the new safe haven? Of course it could. Is it more semiconductors and more the FANG trade, you know, parking in names that overall have stood the test of time and done very well, and that could certainly be possible as well. So in general, I tend to try not to think of what could or should be a safe haven and focus more on the trends and see what the price momentum tells you. Where are people actually rotating their assets? And you can see that by the price and how that price evolves over time. When you think about gold, you have to look at the low in mid-March. It actually bottomed out. The lowest low was March 16th. You can see then the rally out of the lows and a sort of tapering off. And this is when stocks really rallied into June and gold was holding off. But then the acceleration into the high in August. From there, we had what I call a change of character. Something was very different from July to August, September. And you could see a rotation from accumulation phase to distribution phase. When I think of an accumulation phase, it's assets making higher highs and higher lows, which is what you saw in the first left half of this chart. On the right half, you see a rotation to more of a distribution phase, which is lower highs and lower lows. And you can see that the swing highs keep getting lower, the swing lows keep getting lower, and that is the mark of a downtrend. The reason why this is my one chart for today is because I think we are right now sort of in the process of creating a new changing character back from distribution to accumulation phase. And I'll tell you why through a couple examples. Number one, you have this trend starting to change from a downtrend. And if you take the high from August, the high from November, connect that, and then look at this parallel line of sorts, if you connect some of the lows from much of last fall, you can see that this was an acceleration into the August peak. And then sort of this nice, pretty consistent downward trend, parallel channel, lower lows and lower highs. That trend line resistance was confirmed here in mid-December and once again there in late December. And then going into the new year, we've now resolved higher. So we've broken to a new swing high. We've broken above this trend line resistance. The final signal that this has continued from distribution to accumulation, completed that transition, is a break above the November high, which means gold getting around 1970 or so would propel us above that swing high and I think confirm a rotation at least to previous highs, if not much further, which is where I think gold may be headed. The second sort of piece of evidence of that rotation from distribution phase to accumulation phase is the RSI. If you look at the RSI in a bullish phase, when the market's making higher highs and higher lows, you can see the whole range is elevated. So on a pullback, it doesn't really get below 40. On an upswing, it gets to the overbought condition. That all changed here in September when all of a sudden you were in the lower end. You never really got above 60 every time gold rallied. So rallies in an uptrend should get to the overbought region, and it was unable to do so. So it was really more in a bearish region. That has now changed with gold once again reaching that overbought region. And overbought means up a lot. That means that the price has experienced unseasonably strong positive momentum, suggests that there's more accumulation than distribution, there's more demand than supply, there's more buying pressure, buying power than selling pressure, but for whatever reason, it's indicating an influx of buyers pushing gold to a new price peak. So the RSI rotating from bearish phase to more of a bullish configuration is evidence point number two. Number three, I think it's just the way that it played through the Fibonacci retracements and the 200-day moving average. You can see back in March when it traded below the 200-day moving average for a couple days and then rotated back above. We saw a very similar pattern here in November. So getting down to that long-term smoothing mechanism and rotating back more positive is pretty key. What would tell me that the strengthening gold thesis is incorrect? Well, I would say connecting the lows here, I don't have the line drawn, but if you take the low from November, connect that to the low in December, lines up pretty well with some of the swing lows we had there in late December. I think that's a great way to track this uptrend. As long as we remain above that trend line, I would say the short-term uptrend is certainly in play. A break below that trend line would suggest to me to be a little more concerned. And number two would be a failure of gold to get above that November high. We're approaching a key level of resistance. I think the completion of that transition from distribution to accumulation means breaking above trendline resistance, breaking to new interim swing high, and then finally getting above that significant high in November. If that fails, if gold, you know, becoming overbought, if it finds resistance here and then ends up being more of a double top sort of pattern, and we come back down, it tells you that the uptrend is not strong enough. There's not enough buying power to push a gold much further than it's arisen already. However, overall, I would say, you know, what I've talked about in some of my previous videos is overall, I can see the relationship between the S&P 500 in 2021, very similar to the S&P 500 in 2010, which is what happened the year after the 2009 market low. Ended up, stocks sold off in January, February, had a short-term pullback there and gave back some of the gains from the end of 2009. I could see a similar pattern here. And in that case, I could see a scenario where gold serves as a safe haven, certainly in the first half of the year as stocks flounder, sort of fluctuate. And I could see gold, silver, precious metals, and really broader, some of the commodity complex doing stronger, doing better and outperforming stocks in the first half of the year. That's my one chart for today. Hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions or feedback, please take a moment and put a comment below the video and let me know what you are thinking about gold in the first half of 2021. Have a great year and a great day. This is Dave Keller from Market Misbehavior. Take care.